The following program is being brought to you on the Seventh Wave Network. For more information about our network and to check our additional show hosts and topics of interest, please visit SeventhWaveNetwork.com. The Voice America Talk Radio Network is the worldwide leader in live internet talk radio. Visit voiceamerica.com. The views and ideas expressed on the following program are strictly those of the host or guests and do not necessarily reflect the views and ideas held by the Voice America Talk Radio Network, its staff, and management.
Welcome. It's time for expansion. It's time for vibrational attunement and channeled messages with the mothers. This is Conscious Conversations with Angela Blaha. In our program today, you will learn about new states of consciousness and seek unity within yourself. Now, here is your host, Angela Blaha.
Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for listening in today. I'm Angela Blaha. I am so excited today to have Lisa Transcendence Brown with me. We are consciously discussing multi-dimensional consciousness and mastery. Lisa is such an amazing being of light and understands the evolution we are experiencing on Earth today and the creation of our new Earth. Welcome and thank you, Lisa, for being with us today. So we are consciously talking about multidimensional consciousness. Yeah. What this topic is, like, my topic and your topic, right?
Because
it's what I've been working on for about the last 9 months or so. And yeah. So can you, like, explain to us a little bit more about what multidimensional consciousness is?
I can. There are different ways to do this, so I tend to simplify everything because if we get too much in our head about it, it gets really complicated.
Perfect.
So for me, it doesn't have to be complicated. One, we just have to be open and really want to listen and know. And from that wanting and that desire, the information makes more sense to us. So everybody here on Earth is evolving. Whether they are conscious or aware or not. And basically, this is about the vibrational frequency of everything has been raised so high. Everybody came here to evolve, but they may not be aware of that yet. And there's what we call, and I know a lot of your listeners probably already know this, but I'm just going to do it like simply. There is a phase we go through for where everybody starts to wake up. And for their journey, for their time, according to the experience that they chose here as a soul. And the more human we are, the less this makes sense. And I do separate everything into human and higher self or human and soul or universe because it's a way of explaining things. Mm-hmm. But basically, the old way, when the vibrations hit high, then they force us, I'm going to use words here, to become conscious, whether we like it or not. And so in our days, when it was time for us to wake up, then every one of us entered into opening our consciousness in our way. And some it's easy, some it's intense. It can be quite extreme, or it can be something very simple. It doesn't matter. Each one of us chose a different journey here. I chose the extreme journey here. I got to do the dramatic, intense way. But that comes into play in an awesome way later when we start what we call quantum jumping and moving through realities really fast. But consciousness means being aware, opening your heart, and wanting something different than the old ways. And when we start to wake up, there's a yearning within our soul. There's a desire for something more. Life doesn't make sense anymore. The outside world, it doesn't compute. We're looking at things, and we're looking at lack of integrity. We wake up to lack of love, and all of these things. We want more, but we don't quite know what all is going on. There's this this longing, this feeling of like missing home for a lot of the star seeds and galactics here. There is this isn't fulfilling part, or that's where a lot of people, basically we realize things just don't match up anymore. And a lot of people, we don't fit in, and we start trying to figure out what's wrong with us. A lot of people go into that mode and all. Others do it a different way. But basically, everything is a vibration of frequency. And when we start waking up, we start feeling the vibrations of other things. We start feeling too much. We start feeling and seeing vibrationally, but we don't quite understand that's what's going on. We can see truth through the way that we feel. And our senses start becoming very enhanced. And what will happen is for a lot of people, their world will either start to, I'm going to use words here because it's not technically true, but it's how it works to the, if you will, the unconscious, is that things will start getting removed. Their health will start to go. Their job will go. Their family, something will happen with their relationships. And every one of these things are to get our attention and to wake us up. They're to open our heart, and they're to help us move out all of those old realities and move us out of what we call separation consciousness, which means we, the more human we are, the more we live for ourselves. It's all about us and what we're here to achieve in the world, all just for us. And everybody has to move out of separation consciousness back into unity consciousness. And this is a remembering of what we forgot. And it comes through energetically through our consciousness. And so everybody has to become fully conscious again. There's not one person on earth that's not going to experience this in some way, shape, or form. The only difference is whether one's conscious and aware and participating and choosing what they want in their world, or if they're waiting until everything happens to get their attention, to push them. And because now we're in such high vibrations, what's happened is there was a gridwork that held everything in place before, consciousness-wise, and that gridwork collapsed in December, full-blown. It's been collapsing for years, but we went full-blown in December, and now there's no support for the old ways. So every time somebody wants to go back into the old ways, it's not supported, and that reality collapses. It's a vast subject.
Right.
That can be explained very simply if we have experienced it. And that's what a lot of people don't understand, is you actually have to have the experience to understand these things, which is why so many have to experience so much. This is why a lot of us do the work we do, is to assist others with waking up, to understand more. That's why we share knowledge, is to help with the understandings so that it can be easier. And we can actually choose and have a lot of fun, because it can be awesome and amazing, and it can be quite intense. Right. But when you have an understanding that's different, a different perspective, then you approach it and you work with it differently. And you actually do it because you want to, not because your universe, because this is about each one of us has our own individual universe that merges through consciousness, and we connect with that universe. So if we are not wanting to do the journey, then our universe is okay. Let's do this for you. And then it's not a whole lot of fun. Besides that, the physical body upgrades that everybody is going through now, the physical body has to upgrade and evolve, because it has to hold what we call hold light. And light brings everybody back to a place of love, back to a place of unity, back to a place of peace within themselves. We call it the inner journey. It's called many things. It depends. It doesn't matter what we call it, and we can call it all kinds of things. But basically, it's one reclaiming themselves and stepping fully back into power again from the inside and evolving energetically through their own consciousness. And when we do this, we have access to multiple dimensions intentionally, instead of experiencing them every once in a while. or experiencing them but not knowing that's what that was. Especially when we open up to the higher dimensions, our world gets a bit bizarre. Because bizarre is a part of the journey. And a lot of people don't understand that, and they start questioning their sanity. And for me, when I started stepping into a role, because this is everybody stepping into a role, serving a purpose, and contributing now. The days of the old where everybody got to be oblivious are gone. You don't get to be oblivious anymore. Something's going to get your attention to wake you up. So does that help?
Yeah. I want to go back to, you know, how does one open the heart and the mind? For me, it's easier to open my mind than it is my heart because I am one of those starseeds who long to go home, right? And so for me to hang out here on the earthly plane and not have that and open my heart to unity here seems to be very hard for me. Does that make sense?
You actually have to really want it, and you have to seek it, and you have to desire it enough to make it happen in your world. One is to start taking advantage of, we have to connect to what is sacred again. And so a lot of us will start to wake up, but we don't quite understand how to do the journey. This is becoming, coming back to what we forgot. And in order to come back to what we forgot, we have to open our heart, because our whole existence, let's see how I word this, it is based upon our heart being open or closed.
Right.
And so basically it's intentionally doing everything, intentionally connecting, intentionally. When I was we go through a process where we have to open our heart. And it was get out there and connect with people, Lisa. Get out there and make a difference. Get out there and get in service. Start teaching the classes. Help other people understand. Get out in nature. Connect with nature. Go to that place that you're happy. It doesn't matter what it is, but you have to connect to your happy place. Because if you're trying to do it from any other place or space, you're feeding your head. And so it's more about making it a priority and getting up each day. I had to get up each day and force myself to do the things that were not natural, go out in nature. And actually sleep is a big one. Most don't understand the ridiculous amount of sleep we have to wake up. Because we wake up in our sleep. We integrate light in our sleep. And when photonic light activates in our body, it knocks us out and it's foggy, groggy. And our memories start to go. There's a lot of things that occur along this process, but basically we have to really want it. If we don't want it enough, then we're not willing to do anything. And so basically, the way I explain it is that our human mind, when I started seeing how everything works, our human mind, actually, its job is to stop us from waking up. So we don't listen to our human mind. We say, nope, this is what I'm doing today, and we override it.
Right.
Does that help?
Yep. That totally makes sense.
You have to be stronger than your mind is.
Right. That's hard for, you know, living in Earth, which seeks duality, right? Because that's, you know, it's a part of who we are, being the mind.
It is and it isn't. It is for a while. It's very challenging. This is a challenging process. It's going to challenge everything we've got. It's going to challenge everything we've ever experienced. It's going to challenge every mentality, every belief. We have to completely reconstruct. We deconstruct our old belief systems. We reconstruct our world from the inside out. And as we do it, our physical body upgrades. But we actually get out there and we connect with other people who are conscious. And if they're not around us, we make it happen. Whether it be online. Some people live in places where they can't connect as well. So we get online and we work. I started working online years ago, and I dedicated myself to consciousness. Because most don't understand, if you're not dedicated to consciousness, you're not dedicated to yourself. Because technically, at our core, we're just energy. We're conscious energy.
Right.
And so if we're not dedicated to consciousness, then we don't care about ourselves or others. So it's more about our priorities and what we really want. And if we want it enough, this is why things happen in people's worlds. They don't want it enough. So our universe is, okay, here, let me help you out. Let's help you want it a little bit. And that's when things start to happen where people don't understand. Because the program for our exterior world is inside our body. And as masters, we go inside. And we actually start rewriting the program. It's really cool for us to do it this way.
Right.
But it's up to each person to actually really want it enough.
Exactly. That totally makes sense. So, Lisa, we're going to take a little bit of a break, and we'll be right back to talk more about multi-dimensional consciousness.
Thank you.
The Voice America Seventh Wave Channel. Be extraordinary. Be the change.
In Angela's book, Show Me How to Remember Your Power Through Self-Love and Forgiveness, you'll find an empowering book filled with messages of love and forgiveness. She gives powerful ways to use your own courage, strength, and love to heal your emotional and mental body. You can find the book at Amazon or visit Angela's website at angelablaha.com. The book is available in paperback and Kindle formats. Step back into your power. Get Angela's Show Me's at angelablaha.com. Sometimes in the busyness of daily living, we can forget who we truly are as spiritual beings, with intent and purpose fueling our goals and dreams. Remembering begins with navigating belief structures, family or cultural expectations and history, so we can find our way. Listen in to Timeshare with host Marie Jackson. Marie and her regular contributors discuss life's questions, challenges, obstacles, and rewards, all bringing us to the spirit of who we are. Timeshare with Marie Jackson can be heard live every Thursday at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific Time on 7th Wave.
The Voice America 7th Wave Channel.
You are listening to Conscious Conversations. To connect with Angela Blaha or her guest today, please call into the program at 1-866-472-5795. That's 1-866-472-5795. You may also send an email to angelablaha005@gmail.com. Now, back to Conscious Conversations.
Welcome back, and we're here with Lisa Transcendence Brown, and we are talking about multi-dimensional consciousness. Lisa, before the break, we had, you had talked a little bit about photon light and the activation of it and how we need sleep. Can you talk about that a little further?
I can. You asked about opening the heart. When our heart opens, it activates the light inside our body for us to wake up. And I'm going to talk the way I talk just because it simplifies everything, okay?
Perfect.
So when that light comes on, and this is why a lot of people will hit rock bottom, is because the light is so dim that when we hit rock bottom, all of our protection mechanisms, all of our stubbornness gets stripped away.
Mm-hmm.
And we stop fighting the process. We stop fighting what's natural to us, which is opening our heart. But as a human, everything has shut down, and we put walls up, and we block ourselves. And so this is about stripping away for the really human, the really stubborn one, the one that's really separated off from the self themselves as source. We have to hit rock bottom. We have to have that breaking point, because that breaking point is what breaks our stubbornness and our fight and our resistance to a process that has to occur for every one of us. So if we can understand that, then we actually take ourselves to the breaking point without having to break, which is kind of cool. It's another mastery tool. There are many mastery tools. Actually, we utilize absolutely everything that we encounter or have access to in order to turn everything around. And so photonic light is what occurs in your body when your heart opens fully and there's no protection mechanisms in the way. And when your heart opens, it shuts off like a chain reaction in your body and it starts zooming through. You can feel the energy in your body when this occurs. It'll start zooming through your body. This is your consciousness, and it starts activating everything that was dormant and asleep to wake up. And this is why so many people are going through all the physical body things. Now, the more out of alignment we were, the more asleep we were, the more unconscious we were, the more our body goes through, because everything's held in the physical body and our energy field. And your energy field, which is the unified field of consciousness, has to merge with the physical body. And so what happens is when you go to sleep, that light that activates can integrate into your physical body and upgrade it for you. And when you go to sleep, your body will repair itself. It will heal itself. It will clear all the density. But it's a process that takes years. It's not an overnight thing. So this is a process that everybody has to choose to actually be interactive with. We have to really want it, otherwise it happens for us, and we don't get a choice. So this is about intention, this is about focus, this is about choosing, and realizing that it can be an amazing experience if we're actually interactive with it and choosing to participate, rather than waiting till everything happens to us, if you will. Because nothing actually happens to us, it's for us, but we don't get it at the time.
Right.
Photonic light carries knowledge. Photonic light carries health. Photonic light carries love. Photonic light carries everything. And it makes us quantum beings again. It gives us the ability to walk in multiple dimensions. So we're not limited to the old one anymore. So the more light that we activate, and you can do it easily. There are many ways to activate light. Put yourself in a place of being really happy. Anything that opens your heart, anything that gives you the fuzzy wuzzies that you absolutely love, where you're in a very relaxed state and there's no battle with your head. You can go out in the sun and you can activate light. You utilize everything that's available to you. Vitamin D, you want to up your light quotient. But what happens, and a lot don't understand, is when you activate your light, then all of your density, all your separation, all that was hidden is going to come up for you to see it. And this is where it becomes complicated, if you will, is because we hold judgment. We didn't want to see that. It wasn't comfortable. And we don't understand we have to. All that stuff's got to come up. All those feelings that were hidden, all that discomfort, it's got to go. And every feeling tells us something. Everything that occurs in our world tells us something. Part of becoming a master again is evolving back into our true, pure, divine essence self, full of power again, and reclaiming ourselves. And so for our human aspects, we were taught not to make ourselves a priority, focus on the outside world. And we have to completely reverse our world and go inside and realize, wow, I got to come first now. I got to love myself. I have to give myself what I need, and I call it giving ourselves permission, because we don't give ourselves permission to take the day off. We don't give ourselves permission to stop everything and focus on ourselves. And we have to actually say, no, I come first right now. And then once we put ourselves first, consciously and with intention, then our whole world starts to turn around, and our universe will actually start bringing awesome things to us, to assist us. And things become really amazing. But we have to reverse the process of not caring about ourselves, because this is returning to a love that is so pure that everything is sacred. And we function from this place. It's a new existence. It's completely different than the old way. It's out of respect. We hold respect. We hold integrity. We hold love. We hold these things. And in the process, everything within us that isn't that, all the judgment, it goes. There's no duality. There's no battle between the head and the heart anymore, because as your heart opens, your mind follows that. You start listening to your heart. It runs your world. Now, for a while, you'll be clearing anything out that's not love. So every time something comes up, we have to see it and go, wow, there's more. our human goes, oh, I went backwards. I did it. I went back again. And that's not the way this works. That's a mindset. And this means challenging our mindset. It's basically, wow, there was more energy in my body. I need to bring that up and out. And so we intentionally start clearing at a really fast rate. And as we do, our whole world changes. We transform everything into light. We speak in light. We do a lot of cool things that typical humans can't do. But this means embracing ourselves fully and committing ourselves to making a difference in the world, making a difference for ourselves. It's a complete existence overhaul and full body overhaul too. The difference is we understand that everybody has to do this, and so we decide, wow, I'm going to get on board with this. I'm going to participate in it so I actually get to enjoy it. Because all of our lack goes, our abundance is fully returned. Everything we forgot comes back again. But we have to choose it. We live and exist in utter and complete peace. It's very different here.
Right.
Photonic light is a higher frequency than we are as a human, so it shuts us down. Being awake with our eyes open interferes with the process at first. And then after we have activated and held enough light, we're able to, I'm using after and before just for explanation purposes, but all right. along the way. This is happening every day to people.
Right.
A lot of people don't understand what that is because they can't see the purposes and the reasons in things. And we have to actually open our heart and expand our mind in order to see because vision is different here.
Right.
But when we start doing this, we see differently, and we can see all things. You can see different timelines. You get to choose the reality you want. You can pick what you want to be. You completely rework yourself. It's awesome. And you're fully supported by your universe, which is cool. It's when we go into lack and say, I'm not enough, I don't have enough, I'm not going to do this, I'd rather be unconscious because I don't like my world changing. And that our universe kicks it up and says, okay, let's help you. Let's move you along because you don't want to listen. And that's where all of the humans, we call them lessons. But basically, they're just experiences to help us remember again. Because we don't want to listen, we need proof to get our attention. And our experiences in our physical world are our proof. And so what will happen is we go, wow. As we become conscious, we realize we don't need the proof anymore. We get the point. Okay, universe, stop it. I'm tired of all of this stuff. And we actually get on board, and we start participating, and we start making it a priority. And as we do, everything turns around. It's really cool. The difference is the unconscious being hasn't had enough experiences yet. And each time we need a new experience to show us something, it occurs in our world, and it's happening 24/7. If you look collectively, collectively, everybody on Earth is waking up. But there were many of us that have been doing this for years, and we've dedicated everything to this in order to go ahead as gatekeepers and open what we call portals and hold the gates open.
Right.
Of the fifth dimension, sixth dimension, the higher dimensional consciousness. A lot of us work in all these other dimensions 24/7. For me, it's an awakening state. It's also in a sleep state because we don't understand that sleep is our access to the other dimensions when we can't do it in a waking state. And so we utilize the sleep state. It's a very important place. We close our eyes because when you close your eyes, you shut down your brain's ability to be in control. And you can go inside and you can hear your higher self guidance. You go inside and you can feel truth. And so we start going inside our body and listening and paying attention. And it tells us what to do. And then there's other ways, because there's tools that we call of navigation, which is why I wrote the books.
Mm-hmm.
You'll have to tell me where you want to go.
So it seems like the major point, or one of the major points, is to stop with the distractions outside of ourselves, close our eyes, go inward, take extreme care about who we are, why we're here, you know, what our conscious level is, and to, you know, almost surrender into the experience of awakening. So we're going to talk a little bit more about this in a few minutes. We're going to take a short break and then we'll come right back.
Be visionary. This is the Voice America Seventh Wave Channel.
In Angela's book, Show Me How to Remember Your Power Through Self-Love and Forgiveness, you'll find an empowering book filled with messages of love and forgiveness. She gives powerful ways to use your own courage, strength, and love to heal your emotional and mental body. You can find the book at Amazon or visit Angela's website at angelablaha.com. The book is available in paperback and Kindle formats. Step back into your power. Get Angela's Show Me's at angelablaha.com.
Are you a spiritual seeker? Have you always pondered the deeper questions in life? Have you looked at many spiritual paths and found some answers, but are looking for more? The Open Door, brought to you by the Summit Lighthouse, brings you each week practical spiritual teachings and tools that promote self-mastery, higher consciousness, and the opportunity to connect with the Ascended Masters. Join Tom Schumacher and Terry Kennedy as we explore the universe of spirituality, live every Tuesday at 11 a.m. Pacific, 2 p.m. Eastern Time on the Seventh Wave Channel.
This is the Seventh Wave Channel on the Voice America Network.
You are listening to Conscious Conversations. To connect with Angela Blaha or her guest today, please call into the program at 1-866-472-5795. That's 1-866-472-5795. You may also send an email to angelablaha005@gmail.com. Now, back to Conscious Conversations.
Welcome back, everyone, and we're here with Lisa Transcendence Brown. Lisa, we were talking about sleep and photon light and how it activates the body. And I know that I have a lot of clients, and I know many people are experiencing the physical pain and illnesses. Do you want to talk a little bit more about that as well?
Okay. Well, we can go at this from every direction. Basically, when photonic light activates in the body, it goes straight to the source of what's out of tune, because everything is a frequency here.
Right.
So what it will do is it'll go straight to your compromise of yourself as a soul. It'll go straight to everything that's out of alignment in within you. And that's not a judgment thing. What it is our body holds an immense amount of frequencies. And everything of a low frequency is fear, blame, shame, guilt, lack, judgment, all of those things. Greed, selfishness, anything that's separation. What will happen is it's in the bones, it's in the muscles, it's in the teeth, it's in the skin. And what photonic light does is it starts moving through your body and it starts targeting, if you will. Remember, I'm using my words. Everything that is not in it, that is not of the highest vibration of love. So what will happen is if we're holding judgment or lack or grief or blame or victim mentality anywhere in our body, it goes straight to that and it triggers it to come up and out. Now, as a human, we don't understand that's what's going on. So when we get angry or we want to cry, we think there's something wrong with us, or when our body has pain, our mentality is to go to there's something wrong with me and we try to fix it. Instead of understanding, oh, my body is waking up. Oh, my body needs love. My body needs kindness. I need to assist the process. I need to go to sleep. I need to get out in nature. Because you can go outside and lay your body on the ground and it will actually assist with balancing out the magnetics of your body. You can go hug a tree and what's funny is this is very simple process if we really want to hear it. If it's not, it's very complicated because we don't want to listen, so it takes actually more words and explanations to explain it to somebody who doesn't want to hear.
Right.
When our heart's shut down, we don't want to hear. So then you start talking to the human mind. But when the heart is open, it's very simple. It's like go outside, and that person could go, okay, I get that. The human mind wants a lot of proof. It's like, well, convince me. And we started understanding a long time ago, we're not here to convince anybody. We just wait long enough, they'll start suffering, and their heart will open, and they'll go, oh, I get it now. Let me make this a priority. And that's kind of how it works.
Right.
This is why we don't worry about others, because we know that when it's their time, they're going to go through it for them. Our difference is we share the information for those who are ready and who want to do the journey differently, because we don't have to suffer anymore.
Right.
Now,
it's almost like
body upgrades are intense along
right.
the way. We held all of our separation and our human experiences, the programs for them, are held in the physical body, in our cellular memory. And we start going through molecular restructuring. And now I'm going to talk a couple words just for the sake of, because you have to go into quantum physics to understand a lot of this, but not from the brainy way. It's cool
exactly.
because we simplify quantum physics, because this is how we live. Photonic light brings back your knowledge. Photonic light brings back what you forgot. Photonic light zooms through your body, and it obliterates your old realities for you. And human says, uh-oh, my world's falling apart. Not understanding it's not falling apart. Everything's about to come together in a higher frequency, but we got to release all the old stuff that was housed in the body. The body has an intelligence of its own, and mm-hmm. it has to upgrade and release the old density. Because for physical ascension, the body's got to come along with you. It's your vessel into the other dimensions, if you will.
Right, because we're leaving separation, so we have to work as one being.
Exactly. But you don't do that and fight. And as humans, we don't understand we have resistance. We don't understand that we're shut down. We don't even know we're unconscious. We think,
right.
and I'm going to use verbs here, we think we're going to like, but I'm a good person. I love everybody. But we don't understand, this is a completely different love. This is a profound love that when you feel it, it overtakes your whole body and it envelops every part of you. And it's sacred and it's beautiful. And when you have that experience, you carry that forth into the world. And
exactly.
you use it to touch everybody and everything from that place. But you can't do that if you don't hold that love yourself.
Exactly.
So
I've felt that.
Here. I'm sorry, sweetheart. What?
I have felt that love. You know, I channel a group of energy beings called the Mothers, and I
yes.
feel that every time that I channel with them, and it's mm-hmm. it's indescribable. Like you can't bring it into. I cannot bring it into words that right. describe okay. the. Okay. And it's not emotion, because there is no emotion attached to pure love. It's just a way of being that is
pure
indescribable.
Love is the emotion.
Right. Right. But we don't sense
yeah.
that much here mm-hmm. in the human body.
Well, you do, because one of the processes that we go through is we wake up, we start to channel. And see,
right.
this is a progressional journey. So for me, when I started to wake up, I had the heart, one of the heart, I call them harsh landings. We go kerplunk and we wake up in the human world and we look around going, uh-oh, I'm on the wrong planet. Something's wrong here. I don't belong here. Mm-hmm. And that's what we do as galactic and starseeds.
Right.
Is we look at things and realize, this is messed up. I don't want to be on this planet anymore. And then that just starts a whole other thing.
Right.
Yeah, it's huge. But when you channel, you're connecting to a vibration of another dimensional aspect of yourself. And you're raising your vibrational frequency to connect with that feeling, that vibration, so that you can experience it within you. So like when you said, I channel, I started out channeling too.
Mm-hmm.
But then there comes a point where you have to move beyond channeling. But what happens is, so it's important to understand when you channel, you raise your frequency really, really high.
Right.
And then when you raise your frequency really high, it's like, okay, time to go to sleep. Have you ever experienced that when you channel?
Most, for me, it's usually the opposite. Like, I get so energized that I can't sleep.
Cool. Okay. Good. That's another. All right. Yeah. Awesome. Because what happens is that actually raises your energy really, right. really high. Because what happens is when you hit that frequency and that starts tuning your body, that starts tuning your energy, that starts the merging process with you as your higher self aspect. But what a lot of people do is they'll channel and then they'll disconnect and shut down and then say, okay, I'm done channeling. Now let me go do my day. And for us, we don't disconnect.
Right.
We have to maintain that frequency, hold that love, hold that purity in every moment of our day, in every part of our body, 24/7. We don't shut down anymore. Because that feeling that everybody longs for is the feeling that you connect to when you channel. This is why I tell a lot of the clients that I work with or those that I work with, go channel your higher self. Because people are like, I want that connection, but I'm missing it. Go channel. Mm-hmm. But then expect at some point in time, once you've channeled enough, that you have to walk as that essence. You have to walk as that being. You have to hold that frequency within yourself. You have to get in service. You have to start making a difference. You have to bring that information forth. So we don't get to disconnect. We have to hold the integrity because those frequencies are so high. They're of purity. They're of integrity. They're of pure love. And they right. restore a consciousness here on Earth. There's a grid work in the unified field. When your heart is open, when your mind is open, then you become the unified field. Unity, consciousness, all the same thing, different words, broken down into different aspects and ways to describe what we're going through.
Right.
But your whole existence changes because you come from that place. You hold that frequency, and there's no more outside guidance anymore. And so once we start channeling, we realize there's a higher power.
Right.
And we start opening up to that higher power to guide us. We ask, okay, what do I do next? And what we do is we let go of the need to control our world, and we ask our higher self guidance, which is us in another dimension trying to help us and guide us and bring us all those amazing things. What do I do next? You give up the need to control, and right. you turn the power over to your higher self versions of you. And as you do this, each time you embody a little bit more of that frequency. When you go to sleep, you integrate these frequencies into your being. When you wake up, you have new awarenesses. This is what epiphanies are. This is what synchronicities are. All of these things are.
Right.
When you have an epiphany, that's your new realization. You have anchored that light in your physical body. Which is another whole process that we go through in anchoring light. Foggy, groggy, the body swells up. We walk around with bags under our eyes. We look like we've been through hell.
Yes, we do.
Oh, yeah, I mean, there's no fluffy about any of this. It's a reality of our new way of existence and how things are. Energy runs your world because you are energy. So when you start connecting with the energy and you fully open up to it, then your body starts going through this massive upgrade process. And it's basically your universe saying, finally, she got out of the way. Finally, she stopped fighting. Finally, it's about time. Let's bring her her abundance. Let's bring her her purposes. Let's bring her all the things she really wants. Before now, she wasn't willing to listen. She wanted to run the show. She wanted it her way. She didn't like the idea of not having this. This was more important to her. So it's more about understanding what's really important and learning to utilize absolutely everything to assist us on our journey, to go in the different direction. And in the different direction is into a higher frequency. Because technically, Earth went through physical ascension and completed the process in December, if you will. But yet everybody on Earth doesn't understand that, so now they're getting beaten to death with frequencies and light upgrades and stuff so their body can upgrade and bring them through.
Right.
And not understanding their physical body is in a higher frequency now. and everything in their physical body that is not of that highest frequency possible, it's got to leave the body. It's got to go.
Right. So basically, in order to stop the pain and suffering of the body is to go outside and get in nature, hug a tree, do some sleeping, just sort of like embody the whole energy of the upgrade. So we're going to take another short break, and then we'll come right back, and we're going to talk about the grids and what happened in December.
The Voice America 7th Wave Channel. Seek greater awareness.
In Angela's book, Show Me How to Remember Your Power Through Self-Love and Forgiveness, you'll find an empowering book filled with messages of love and forgiveness. She gives powerful ways to use your own courage, strength, and love to heal your emotional and mental body. You can find the book at Amazon or visit Angela's website at angelablaha.com. The book is available in paperback and Kindle formats. Step back into your power. Get Angela's Show Me's at angelablaha.com. Sit back, relax, breathe. Reconnect to the still small voice within. Take the time to make a weekly visit to the sounds of the heart. With host Sandy Goldstone, this unique program will help you cultivate and strengthen your heart's connection and feel love, beauty, and joy. You don't need to fear or suffer. Heed the call. Say yes to living from the heart's truth. Tune in live every Tuesday at 5 p.m. U.S. Pacific Time on the Voice America 7th Wave Channel. Join the evolving consciousness of humanity.
This is the Voice America 7th Wave Channel.
Listening to Conscious Conversations. To connect with Angela Blaha or her guest today, please call into the program at 1-866-472-5795. That's 1-866-472-5795. You may also send an email to angelablaha005@gmail.com. Now, back to Conscious Conversations.
Thank you and welcome back. We are here with Lisa Transcendence Brown. And during the break, I was chatting with Lisa a little bit, and she had made a comment about when you can see, like etherically see, because I was talking about seeing the matrix and seeing the energy patterns like she does. She made a comment about when your heart is open, you can see. So do you want to move further into that, Lisa?
Yeah. Our vision is different here. They're holographic. The entire universe is a hologram. Mm-hmm. But the hologram is visible inside the body. And it's through the activation of the heart opening, and it activates the pineal gland, which has a crystal in it. It's got to be decalcified. And as our pineal gland activates and upgrades too, and this is where a lot of people are getting headaches, and there's absolutely everything in the physical body is a part of this. But headaches, one of the things it is the pineal gland activating and trying to, the neural pathways, and you'll feel a heartbeat in your head and the head will start exploding. Mm-hmm. That's part of multidimensionality. Mm. And so when the head starts pounding, it's trying to open up those neural pathways, which is the other 95% of the brain that's been shut off. That's where the veils are held, are in your muscles and in your brain. Your heart is a muscle. So your muscles are really important. And so if your heart is shut down, your vision is closed too. So when your heart opens, your vision is returned through this physical, it's an alchemical process that occurs with your physical body. It's an evolution of your physical body. And you go through DNA upgrades and you go through genetic recoding, there is a whole lot of stuff going on that most people have no idea is occurring inside their body because it's so subtle. And it's not visibly seen unless you close your eyes and go inside and pay attention to what's going on inside your body. You have to actually choose to do this in order to see. But there are holograms inside, and you get to see them. And they'll come through as visual imagery. Well, that visual imagery, the more left brain we are, the more it's shut down. There are also frequencies that one hears in their head, and they don't understand that's what they is. And like, oh, there's something wrong with me. I keep hearing these high-pitched tones, not understanding. They're hearing their higher self. They're hearing from another dimension. They're hearing the entire universe. It's all things. I listen to this frequencies 24/7. That's what I write for people all day long.
Right.
Is because we are energy, we communicate through tones and frequencies and sound and feelings. And so when you're in tune with all of those things, then you start to understand differently and everything makes sense again. But vision is through your heart. You close your eyes, you go inside, you sit and you observe and you look at things and then and the hologram will become visible. And you can actually create ways to play with it because you can create holograms too. But what happens is the external hologram is a big screen, TV, if you will.
Right.
But what's inside your body? So when people say, I don't understand why the whole world is doing this, you have to go inside to figure out why that's happening. Because it basically, your access to the hologram outside is inside. And you have to see it inside first. Does that make sense?
Totally makes sense. And
cool.
Yeah.
And when you sleep, your heart, your mind, your muscles, they relax. And when they relax, the grid work for the old matrix was inside the muscles and the bones. The bones are the structures for your whole physical reality. The muscles is the grid work. It's what held the quantum field in place. And what happens is as you sleep and upgrade and you hold this light, your light, as your heart opens and you start getting really interactive with the process, your physical body will start upgrading itself. But if we don't understand what it is, we start going, oh, no, something's wrong with me. And we have to catch ourselves and say, oh, no, there's nothing wrong with me. This is an awesome thing. I've been waiting for this my whole existence. Because just those words change our perception.
Right.
And that perception changes how we deal with things. Because the moment you go to fear, your heart shuts down. And your muscles lock down, and your body goes into resistance mode, and it starts fighting back. And that's what creates suffering.
Right. And we have to realize and change our perception that we are not here for pain and suffering. So as you can tell, Lisa and I can talk about this all day long. So listeners, if this is something you're totally fired up about, like I am and like Lisa is, you know, let us know so we can bring more of this kind of conversation to the show. So Lisa, we only have about 3 minutes until we close. So how can people find you?
Well, I have a website, awakeningtoremembering.com. I'm on Facebook. I have a public page, and I have my personal page. And I write. I have newsletters. And so just go look me up. Go to Facebook. That's where I work most of the time, that and my website. And I have a ton of information up, courses. We do everything. I do activations that actually take you inside in order to do this yourself. It explains everything. My gift, we all have amazing gifts. Every one of us are here to share. Our job is to utilize those in order to be able to share and become a contributing part of society and create the change. And as we do that, more gifts come forth. So one of my gifts is knowledge. I have access to an abundance of knowledge. I'd have to speak and record 24/7 to share it all, which is why we do these things.
Right.
So. Yeah, one of those ways works. How's that?
Right. Yeah, and I know you have a couple books out, so people can... What are the names of those books?
Yeah, well, they explain the process. And so it from a very different perspective, and they give tools of navigation. So they're here to take the old perspectives, and it flips everything into a completely different place. And they also deliver a frequency that open our heart and bring us back to that remembering from inside. So I do. And a few more on the way.
Right. Awesome. I can't wait. And so is it, one last question, is it really important, and I'm assuming that it is, that remembering is moving forward as a human society?
It is. Well, it returns everybody to our higher states of consciousness, back to the days of Lemuria and Atlantis, when things were, where we functioned at a higher state of consciousness and galactically, right, in a very different way. It restores peace. It restores unity. It restores love. It restores everything that everybody's seeking, but they don't understand that they have access to. So remembering brings everything back that we forgot. It removes the veil, and we're fully conscious again. It's a beautiful, beautiful experience if we allow the process and actually want to be a part of it.
Exactly. And allowing the process is really all about wanting to be the process.
And assisting. So we actually have to take an active part in the process. We don't sit around and wait for things. We have to say, I really want this. And then we have to invest ourselves and everything in the process. Because if we're not invested in it, we're not invested in ourselves.
Right. Okay, so that concludes our show today. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lisa, for being a guest today. And again, viewers or listeners, if you like this kind of conversation of opening up and becoming, you know, more conscious about what we, who we are and why we're here, please let me know. And thank you again. Take care, everyone.
Thank you for tuning into this week's edition of Conscious Conversations. Be sure to join Angela Blaha for another edition next Tuesday at 10 a.m. Pacific Time, 1 p.m. Eastern Time on the Voice America 7th Wave channel. Until our next meeting, have an extraordinary week.